Afternoon, everybody. Your old buddy Dwoodog here. Good Friday, March 29th. It's about 10 to 4 in the afternoon. This is going to be a little bit of a different video than what you normally see. I'm not going to make it a long video. I'm going to try to, you know, keep the ball rolling and not do a lot of yabbling if I can. I should be able to. What we're going to do today is we're going to make some... That's going to be loud on the video. We're going to make some air-fried frozen hamburgers because your old buddy Dwoodog finally gave in and bought an air fryer because his deep fryer packed it in. Now, I only used the deep fryer for hamburger for French fries, but after doing a little bit of research and seeing that you can do a lot more with the air fryer than the deep fryer, sort of, and it's much more healthier. And I did try making some fries in the air fryer. They're okay, they're better than the oven, but they're definitely not better than deep frying. If you want the authentic restaurant taste fries, you got to deep fry them, man. There's no two ways about it. Air frying works okay. They don't taste bad, like they're better than the oven, just not as good as the deep fryer. And this is my findings. You can take it with a grain of salt. I'm just telling you. I'm no air fryer expert. I've only owned the thing about 3 days now. So this is my second or third time making a burger. And let's go through it together, see what we can come up with. All right. Got our stock frozen burger patties. Don't mind the mess. I need a plate. Probably should go over the deep fryer. This is the one I bought, the Ninja 3.8 liter capacity, which is basically 4 quarts. So liters and quarts are fairly interchangeable. Fits 900 grams of fries. Yeah, I guess, whatever. 75% less fat, super fast airflow, easy to clean, blah, blah. And they show air fries. They show roast Brussels sprouts. I don't like roast Brussels sprouts. I like boiled or steamed Brussels sprouts. I like them just like that. Reheating pizza. Yeah, I guess. Dehydrating. Yeah, maybe. 2 fan speeds with wide temp range. 1260 RPMs at 105. 3100 at 400. All right. Bonus accessory, dehydrating rack. Ninja seems to be the popular model, so we'll stick with that. There she be. Don't mind a little bit dirty on the inside. I made some hash browns this morning. Not hash browns shredded, but hash brown patties like what you get at McDonald's. I've dumped 3 of them in there and had them for breakfast. Worked out okay. Yeah, worked out okay. A lot faster than the oven. Okay, let's get our burgers on a plate. Oh, we don't even need a plate to put them on. We just drop the frozen patty in there. We got to preheat the sucker first, but I'll show you how to do that. This is not really going to be a big instruction video on how to use the unit, just the results I get from the unit. Okay, normally what I do is I like to chop up my vegetables before I get cooking. That way I'm not in a rush. You guys ever seen these? Oven glove? They're no joke, man. They work good. We're gonna put some Armstrong aged cheddar on there. We're making a cheddar cheeseburger, not just regular sliced cheese. Nice tomato. And remember, we're only making one burger, so we don't need that much. Cut that end off. Now, I like my tomatoes cut super thin. All right, that's enough for me. This is Walmart lettuce, which I usually don't buy produce at Walmart, but I was out there, so anybody else throw the first leaf away on their lettuce? I usually do. Okay, you don't need much lettuce for one burger. That's probably good right there. It's probably even more than enough. Okay, because we're making a cheddar cheeseburger. That's good enough. One more little piece. All right, thing here. We're only making one burger here. Bit of relish. A burger without relish is like a day without sunshine. Am I trying to make Big Mac sauce? No. Does it look like Big Mac sauce? Yeah, let's have a little taste of that. Not bad. We preheat this bad boy now. So what we do is we press the on. And the instructions say about 350. I don't think this thing has a 350. Oh, it does. Okay, 350. And we preheat for... Whoops, wrong way. I usually preheat 4 minutes. All right, and we'll come back in 4 minutes when it's preheated. Okay, we're almost done preheating. And then we slam our big old boiger in there. I gotta tell you something about these air fryers that I've noticed. Looks pretty big in there, right? It won't fit two of these burgers. All right, so we go 350, and then we're gonna be turning it over halfway, so it says about 10 minutes or so. I usually go a little bit longer than 10 minutes. Let's do 6. There we go. We'll come back to that in 6 minutes when it's done. One thing I've noticed about these things, when you're buying one, that is the 4-quart, 4-liter roughly. I would say even if you're a single person, get the biggest one you can. Because that thing, I was cooking burgers last night. I think that was the first time I tried the frozen burgers. There's only one will fit in there. And it says from all the videos I've watched and some info, you don't want the food overlapping. You want to make sure there's space for the air to circulate to cook it. Well, if that's the case, you only get one burger in there when they're that big. I mean, if you make little burgers, you know, only like, you know, that big, yeah, I guess. Who wants a little wimpy wussy burger? So, and each burger takes about, I find, at least 15 minutes to cook, give or take, a minute or two. So, if you're cooking burgers for like three people, you're going to be there mucking around forever with the thing. You might as well just cook them in the frying pan, man. I mean, the grease splatter and all that mess all over the stove is brutal. I've done it. I've been there. I bought an electric frying pan. You don't get the grease splatter all over the stove, but there's a lot of grease to clean up afterwards. And you've got the added hassle of cleaning up a big greasy frying pan, because there's a lot of grease that comes out of those when you fry them. Not as bad air frying. I cooked three last night, had to do one at a time. Took me like 45 minutes to cook three little wussy boy frozen burgers. It was kind of a joke, man, but I did it. Here's our sauce. Real cheddar cheese. Yum. My drink. Just under 3 minutes to go. All right, I'll bring you back when the 3 minutes is up. Okay, almost done. Just coming along, coming along. Flip it over. Oh. All right, shove her back in there. Go for 354. I'm gonna do 7 min. All right, I'll bring you back when she's done. Okay, we're at 40 seconds to go. I'm gonna pause it, have a look. Looks like it could do with another, we're gonna give her another flipperoo. What's the temperature of this thing? So what we're going to do is we're going to put our cheese on there, like this. Okay, make sure our cheese is all on there. And we're going to use, oh, hang on, make sure it's on there good and square. Okay, we're going to use the last 40 seconds to melt the cheese. Oh yeah, she's melted on there nicely. That's gonna be a mess to clean off, but dang, it's gonna taste good. Okay, let's see if we can get it over to the bun without it falling off of the spatula, which looks like we can. Okay, and then we're gonna put some tomato on. Some lettuce. Okay, and we'll get a little bit of our sauce and spoon it on there. I think I made too much sauce for one burger, but that's all right. That's a lot of sauce, but I can always say, that's all right. Okay. Let's go in the dining room and take a couple of bites of this thing. There she blows. All right, so far so good. Let's give her a taste. Boom! That's a good burger. One more bite. Bit hot. How about one more bite? This isn't supposed to be an eating video. It's making a burger video. Okay, guys, we're gonna leave it there. Give her a like, comment, subscribe. This is making a frozen burger in the air fryer, Dwoodog style. It's good. That cheese sets it over the top, man. Definitely. If you got cheddar cheese, put it on there, bro. Or sister, whatever. Yeah, it's good. It's good. All right, guys. Sayonara from the Dwoodog's kitchen.